Hello students, welcome to our today's class. In the today's class we are going to learn about super trick for the hybridization. So this hybridization trick is more useful in your competitive examination like JEE and IIT. You can save lot of time while solving these hybridization points. First you take this carbonate ion, the CO3-2. If you take carbon, here central atom is what we have to take carbon. Central atom is carbon. Carbon valency 4 electrons. Here not only 4 electrons, here upside charge negative. Negative means we need to add 2 electrons. Therefore carbon has 6 electrons. Just imagine like that. So now here 3 oxygens are there. The 3 oxygens, each oxygen can form 2 bonds. So 2 electrons one oxygen can use. In that 2 bonds, one is sigma bond, another one is pi bond. So therefore how many sigma bonds did you get here? 3 sigma bonds you got. Here that means 3. 3 sigma bonds means here what is coming here, you take this list. So 3 means what? sp2. So its hybridization is sp2. So only sigma bonds affects the hybridization, not pi bonds. That is why I am taking only sigma bonds, sp2. So generally you know all are bond pairs, so triangular, planar and 120 degrees. One more example if you take, that is a familiar and known example I want to do, that water you take. Here central atom is what? Oxygen. Oxygen is having how many electrons? It is having 6 electrons in its valency shell. Now out of 6 electrons, here see two hydrogens are using 2 electrons. How many pairs are there? 2 lone pairs are there. In the above example no lone pairs, but here lone pairs are there. 2 sigma bonds plus 2 lone pairs. Lone pairs also we need to count. That means 4 sp3. Shape is what? Lone pairs are there. Whenever lone pairs enter, shape will be changed according to the valency shell electron pair repulsion theory. That is why it is a V shape and bond angle is 104. Here see, this is third example, very rare example. In that third example, here I3- we are taking. Central atom is I. I means what? Group, 7th group. 7 means valency electrons, how many are there? 7 are there. So that's what I wrote, 7 electrons. And here one negative charge is there, no? That negative charge means addition of electron. So I added one more electron. Total 8 electrons are there. Out of 8 electrons, 2 electrons are used by the 2 iodines. Those 2 sigma bonds and 3 lone pairs. Now 2 sigma plus 3 lone pairs. That means total 5. 5 means what? sp3d. Here sp3d, but here lone pairs are there, no? Shape will be what? So lone pairs changes. So therefore shape is nothing but a linear shape. You can see valency shell electron pair repulsion theory, you can get this. Bond angle is 180 degrees. Simply you can find out what is that hybridization and all. Last one you'd see this one, that is xenon oxy tetrafluoride. So xenon means it belongs to 8th group element. That means 8A. Okay, 8 electrons are there in its valency shell. You know very well oxygen takes 2 electrons because one is sigma bond, another one is pi bond. There are 4 F, that each F can form one sigma bond. So therefore total how many sigma bonds are there? Total 5 sigma bonds are there, and one more is one lone pair is there. You have to take it. You need not think about pi bonds, only sigma bonds and lone pairs. So 5 plus 1 lone pair, 5 sigma bonds plus 1 lone pair, total 6. That means sp3d2. So hybridization is sp3d2, but lone pairs are there, its shape is quietly different. Okay, even if you get sp3d2 lone pairs, its shape is what? Square pyramidal structure lone pair we are representing like this. Bond angle is 90 degrees. Here this is about our simple trick hybridization. It is more useful for the competitive examination to find it out, hybridization shape and bond angle. So this is our today's video. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.